Hola amigos, soy Blanca de Spanish Connection in Edinburgh, and I'm here today to talk about how to express quantity in Spanish. Before you say anything, I know it's quite easy, isn't it? But I'm not here to tell you how to express quantity in Spanish, like in the common way, the one that you will probably learn in the class or in the textbook. Today, I'm going to give you some of the native ways to express quantity. And we are going to divide the mini lesson in two, like to express big quantity and to express small quantity. Yeah? So if you are ready, let's go for it. As I say, these ways to express quantity, they are not the typical ones that you are going to learn in the class or in the textbooks, like mucho, bastante, demasiado. To accompany, to go with this video, I have wrote a blog as well. And on the blog, you will learn all. I talk about the ones that you probably know, like the typical one, muchos, bastantes, blah, blah, blah. But in this video, we are just gonna focus in the native or not as common, the ones that you probably don't learn on the blogs. Yeah? So to express big quantity, we have a few words. We can say un montón. Un montón means mucho, but like a lot of. It's quite colloquial, yeah? Por ejemplo, últimamente tengo un montón de trabajo. Lately, I have a lot of work. Another word to express a big quantity is mogollón. Mogollón means, like in English, you will use heaps or loads. Por ejemplo, si quieres leer un libro de horror, no compres ninguno. Te puedo dejar uno porque tengo mogollón. If you want to read a horror book, don't buy any. I can't let you one because I have heaps. Another word to express big quantity is a patadas. And a patadas means something big, like in big amounts. For example, en la cena de Navidad siempre hay comida a patadas. At the Christmas dinner, there is always food in big amounts. Another word is amares. Amares means, again, a lot of. We usually use amares when we talk about rain. Like the most common sentence, it would be, está lloviendo amares. That is something similar to, it's pouring rain. And three more. Otra, another, is de más. De más means in excess or too much, too many. For example, Javier está muy cansado últimamente, pero no me extraña, trabaja de más. Javier is very tired lately, but doesn't surprise me because he works too much or he works in excess. Another word that also means in excess or plenty is de sobra. For example, if we are having a deadline at work and someone asks me, are you nervous? I will say, no, no estoy nerviosa. Tenemos tiempo de sobra para finalizar el proyecto. No, I'm not nervous. I think we have plenty time to finalize the project. And the last one to express big amounts is con creces. Con creces means by far, or as well, again, in excess. El otro día fui al cine a ver la nueva película de Almodóvar y superó con creces mis expectativas. The other day, I went to watch the new movie of Pedro Almodóvar and it met my expectations by far. Yeah? So as you see, they are pretty much the same. They mean the same, big amount. It doesn't matter if you choose to use one or another. But it does matter if you choose to use one of these ones or one of the ones that you already know, like mucho. It's quite common, but this one is quite native, and it will make you sound more like a native. Okay, so we have seen the big amounts. Now we are ready to jump how we will express a small amount in Spanish. The first one that we have is contados. Contados means a few or limited. Por ejemplo, si quieres venir al curso de español, necesitas apuntarte porque los espacios están contados. If you want to join the Spanish course, you need to sign in because the spaces are limited. Another way to express small amount is puñado. Puñado means a handful. Por ejemplo, el otro día en la conferencia solo éramos un puñado de personas. The other day at the conference, we were just a handful of people. And the last one, to express a small amount, we will say un pelín. Un pelín means slightly or a little bit. Por ejemplo, if someone asks me, ¿tienes hambre? Are you hungry? I would probably say, un pelín, a little bit, or he trabajado mucho esta semana. Estoy un pelín cansada. I have worked a lot this week and I'm a little bit tired now. So those are the words. Difficult? I don't think so. Let's review. So to express big amounts, we have un montón, mogollón, a patadas, a mares, de más, de sobra, con creces. And to express small amounts, we have contados, un puñado, un pelín. I hope you enjoyed this mini lesson and you start practicing expressing amounts with these words. I promise your friends will be so surprised. Where would you learn that? But as I always say, practice makes perfect. So leave a comment below with one of the words that we just learned and a sentence. And two more things. I also create a PDF that you can download. It's about measures. That is as well another way to express quantity. But it's overused helpful because it's like for food, pretty much, like a jar of, a bottle of, a teaspoon. How do we say those measurements in Spanish? So you want to download it, the link is below. And as well, I have a big announcement because my first ever Spanish online course, it is for beginners, but it's out there, so you can get it. It's an introductory price at the moment, so take advantage because it's not gonna be for long. And you can join it in the link below. So you can read the curriculum, what do we learn, what do we not learn, who is this course for, who is not for. So yeah, have a look. And if you think this course is for you, I will be happy to take you on board. That's all for today. I hope you enjoy and nos vemos pronto. Adiós.